topic is forgotten statesman. Whenever a statesman dies in India, to mark respect, his or her body is wrapped with a national tricolor. And this person died, not just our tricolor, not two, but three different countries' national flag were wrapped on his body to mark respect. Anybody in this room have an idea about that person? He is none other than a man with indomitable courage, exemplary aviation skill, two times former Chief Minister of Orissa, Sri Biju Patnaik. Good afternoon, fellow Toastmaster and guest.
Good afternoon.
Let's understand how he earned respect from these three countries. He was born in Cuttack, Odisha, in the year 1916. At the age of 22, he joined British Royal Air Force as a pilot. Though he was serving for the British, every bit of him was dedicated for India and Indian freedom struggle. He used to secretly transfer the Indian freedom fighters from one location to another without letting the British know. He used to distribute, rather, airdrops, the leaflets containing the message from Subhash Chandra Bose to fellow Indians to spread the flames of independence during his flights. All these sort of things were known to British at one point of time, and he was thrown inside jail till the India got in. After independence, Pakistan's tribal military attacked Jammu Kashmir. With an agreement with the Jammu Kashmir, Indian government took some time for a decision and responded back. By this time, the tribal militia already were in the outskirts of Srinagar. They are about to capture Srinagar. Prime Minister Nehru called the dynamic daredevil, the much decorated pilot of India, Sri Biju Patnaik, for this job. Without wasting any time, Biju Patnaik took 18 of the Sikh regiment soldiers and dropped at the Srinagar airport. They themselves restricted the tribal militia there itself. Throughout the day, he flew many more flights with Indian soldiers. And today, you are seeing Jammu Kashmir as an integral part of India. It was because of his timely action on that day. In the 1965, India and Pakistan were at war. Pakistan's Navy were much stronger with US help. To add more damage to India, Pakistan managed to get support from Indonesia, and a warship from Indonesia was sent back to India, sent back to Pakistan to be used against India. Sensing this threat, then Prime Minister Lal Bahadur Shastri requested Biju Patnaik to handle the situation. Biju Patnaik convinced the President of Indonesia, Dr. Sukarno, and the warship was taken back. It helped India in a much bigger way. Wait. Convincing another nation on a geopolitical warfare is a diplomat's job, Ministry of External Affairs job, Prime Minister's job. Biju Patnaik was a simple pilot. How could he do that? Because Biju Patnaik was the Bhumiputra of Indonesia. In 1947, Indonesia was also struggling for freedom from the Dutch captivity. In the 1940s, in the same year, Prime Minister Nehru organized an inter-Asia conference at New Delhi to provide platform such Asian countries who are seeking independence so that they can voice internationally. Indonesia wanted to send their representative to this inter-Asia conference, but the Dutch did not allow it. The Prime Minister, the Indonesian President requested Nehru to help on this. Nehru knew a man, anything, anywhere, anyhow can do this job is Biju Patnaik. He handed over this seemingly impossible task to bring back two eminent representatives from Indonesia, from the Dutch captivity, and safely brought back to Delhi. Biju Patnaik took a civilian aircraft and headed for Indonesia. Through Singapore, he reached Indonesia, took this two eminent personality, their Prime Minister Muhammad Sahrir and their Vice President Hatta, in his plane. On the return, he faced the civil military aircrafts of Dutch Air Force. Remember, it was no less than a James Bond movie. They were firing at his plane, but he was such a daredevil pilot. He maneuvered his plane such a way that not a single bullet could hit him, and he safely brought back the two leaders to the India. In the same year, for that reason, Indonesia got independence, and he was declared as the Bumiputra of Indonesia, also given as the highest civilian award from the Indonesia. He not only did his daredevil skill in Indonesia, he did it in Russia as well. In World War II time frame, when Russia were struggling with the Germans at the Stalingrad, their ammunitions were almost completed. In the much needed time, Bijapurnaik took the opportunity and provided the ammunition to them, and Russia was saved from the Germans. He won much respect from these countries and several friends in India, but he was not in much limelight. He could be the next Prime Minister after Nehru, as per the British think tank. He could be the Prime Minister in the 1996 and the United Front, but he never chose to do that. You know why? He wanted to uplift his poverty region, own state, Odisha. Being an entrepreneur, he set up industries across Odisha. Being a chief minister, he constructed expressways, dams, steel plants. He even raised the daily wages to up to 3 times for the people. With all the facilities, he could be in a bigger, much limelight. But there was a certain difference across the statesmen, that he was very down to earth. He was very selfless. With that, he wanted to serve the own people. That makes him class effort. That's why he was a forgotten leader. Over to you.